Da, 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 da. Hi guys, Vechs here. Welcome to episode 5 of my Mountain Blade Warband LP. And I was just sitting here listening to the music before I started recording because it's so catchy. Seriously, I love the music in this game. Alright, so on this episode, in the interest of variety, and because I've not really done it much before, I am going to join the Kurgat Khanate. Now, this is not a permanent thing. It is possible after joining a faction to leave. There could be some cost to relations, but, you know, you can do it. You can do it. So, this is the Kurgat Khanate. They're essentially Mongolians, and, yeah, that's pretty much it. I think this could be more challenging than normal, just because taking castles with Kurgat Khanate troops might be more difficult. So let's head to the castle. Actually, let's head to the marketplace real fast and see if I need to sell anything. Nah. I'm still trying to save up that 10,000 gold. All right. Let's head to the castle. Where's the front door? Oh, right there. Oh, this is a neat castle. Let's see. Kurgat Horseman? There's the chest if I own the place, but I don't. He must be up here. This is a very interesting castle. There's an upper level over here. You can look down on the courtyard. That's cool. But this doesn't actually lead anywhere. Okay. Let's head upwards then. This is the first time I've ever been to a Kurgat castle. Am I just a derp? Did I not... Was the king here? Oh, you know, he could be out in the field, now that I think about it. He could be out... Let's see here. Let's go check Dastar Castle up here and see if there's a lord present. Oh, here we go. Tulag Noyan, at your service. I wish to ask you something. I want to know the location of someone. The leader is Sanjar Khan, is his name. And Noyan is the title of rank of a lord. So I think I might be something like Vechs Noyan or something, maybe. Okay. Sanjar Khan. He's in the field and should be close to Dastar Castle. Well, this is Dastar Castle, so that means he's... Ah, there he is. Alright. So let's go talk to this guy and see if he'll accept us. You know, it's entirely possible he might not accept us. Okay. So I'm a commoner. I'm of common birth. I did not take the... You can start as a noble and you get a banner. Once you become... gain enough renown, you can have your own banner. And for me... let's see what he says. Yep, I had a feeling this would happen. Okay. So I'm not awesome enough to become a noble lord yet. Denied! Okay. Well, in the meantime, I suppose I can see if he's got any tasks. It can't hurt to get my reputation up with this guy. There's a villain named Ritman the Quick. He murdered one of my men and has been on the run from judgment ever since. I can't let him get away with avoiding justice, so I put a bounty of 300 dinar on his head. Friends of the murdered man reckon that the assassin may have taken refuge with his kinsmen at Peshmi. You might be able to hunt him down and give him what he deserves and claim the bounty. Then I will hunt him down. And so we've gained some three relation right there. So he's still indifferent. I mean, it'll take a while. My mod will make it happen faster, but it'll still take a while to get up in rank. Alright, so basically this guy killed one of the Khan's men and ran. And he is rumored to be hiding out in the village of Peshmi. So I'm going to head to Peshmi, and I think... Where am I? Wait. There's me. What is that? Kurgat. Oh, deserters versus manhunters. Ooh, I'm going to go help. Yeah, I can move in to help the manhunters. Ah, fantastic. An impromptu battle. Well, that's okay. I'm going to charge. This is going to be over very quickly. Actually, this would be a good time for my throwing weapons. Oh, I'm such a good Kurgat. Look at me. I'm riding on horseback, and I'm throwing stuff at people. Oh, I desperately need points in horseback archery. I am so inaccurate up here. I can barely hit anything. You see why I wanted more than, like, you know, five ammunition? Got him. Yeah. I'm tempted to even bump up the ammunition a little more in the mod, but I guess I'll leave it for now. What's left? Is there a guy left? I guess there is. Oh, yeah. One thing about the Kurgats is their units are mostly mounted, a lot of mounted lancers and horse archers. I think I hit the horse. They can be kind of annoying because they just ride around all over the place and make you chase them down. Did we get them? Oh, now we did. Is that the end of them? Yeah. I think one of the most effective counters to that is to just have like a line of Rodokian sharpshooters, and they can ride around all they want. They're just still going to get shot. We actually lost an archer there. Huh. Well, this is an easy way to gain relation. Look at that guy's mustache. He needs a monocle and maybe a cup of tea. Oh, hey, that could be Amlop. Amlop, because he's British and all. Thank you for your help, sir. Things didn't look well. So that's an easy way to gain relation, except for the fact that... ooh, we'll capture these guys. Ooh, peasant women, yay! Yay, peasant women! Go away. I want the peasant women. Yay, I love me some peasant women. Okay. Except that the relations with manhunters doesn't do anything because they're not a major faction. Right, okay. So let's... Well, damn it. I gotta head back to Tolga real fast and drop these prisoners off. Thankfully, though, I know now to use the control space to advance time really fast. So, prisoners to sell. These guys should give me some money. There we go. That's nice. All right, let's head out now. We need to head to Peshmi. So I think I can double click on my or click on myself to follow. Oh, damn it. So space just stops yourself. Let's head over there. And I can click on myself. Let's hold down control and then press space. And there we go. Whee! Oh my god, I wish that I had played. I have played this game so long and never knew about that. That's amazing. That makes long distance travel so much easier. And it would actually make merchant more bearable, because a lot of merchant time is spent. I'll wait until morning. Okay. I don't want to go running around in the dark trying to find this guy. Okay, let's head to the village center. So this is the village of Peshmi. Let's keep our weapons ready. You there, peasant woman! Hey, I'm talking to you. Come here. Wait, am I still walking? No, come to a stop. Now talk to her. There we go. I am looking for a man by the name of Ritman the Quick. I was told he may be hiding here. Strangers come and go to our village, sir. If he is hiding here, you will surely find him if you look around. Okay, then. Well. Ah! Maybe that's him. Ah! Let's get him! Wait a minute. That's a woman. I'm pretty sure we're looking for a guy. I'm pretty sure he's probably hiding in the shadows of a building somewhere. Like, in... Oh, I'm sorry. I ran into a fence, apparently. Maybe behind a building, or... Yeah, somewhere like there is a good... is a spot, like, the game likes to stick them. Maybe behind here? No? Come out, wherever you are. I'm going to run a spear through your gut. Ooh. Hiding behind a house, are we? Found him. Hello, nervous man. What do you want? I am looking for a murderer by the name of Ritman the Quick. You fit his description. Oh, if you're innocent, drop your sword. You have nothing to fear. We'll go check with the neighbors and see if you're telling me the truth. And now I've got some responses here. They're all going to be the same, but I think let's just try this one and see if it gives me any nobility or renown. Nope, I don't think so. Well, I just need this guy's head. So, don't even try. I'm just going to throw a javelin in your gut. Okay. We've improved some throwing. Nervous man killed by Vexdavian. And I think we're done here. And you see that -2 right there? The populace doesn't like, you know, me hunting down people hiding in their town. Probably because that was his hometown or something, and the people there were sympathetic to him. So now we need to return to Sanjar Khan, who's probably chilling somewhere around Tolga. Warp speed! This is so awesome! This is so awesome! Wow! I'm already back over here. I cannot believe I've played this game for so long and never knew about that. And we can hover the mouse over the... Oh! I should have done that earlier. You just hover the mouse over the town. It tells you what lords are there. Let's go to the castle. There's Akadin Noyan. There's Sanjar Khan. Sanjar Khan! With your stupid haircut. Yeah, maybe I don't want to work for you after all. I could find your claimant and back him or her instead. That'd be kind of cool. Yeah, your haircut's stupid. It's making me not want to work for you. Ew! You've got like a rat tail? Like, wow. I've seen haircuts on rappers that weren't that stupid. Wow. Dude. That is like the worst haircut I've ever seen. He's like bald, and then he's got his bangs left intact, and then he's got like little rat tail braids coming down on either side. You know, I get that it's probably practical to wear some styles of helmets with your head completely shaved, but that still doesn't change the fact that he looks stupid. Okay. Put a helmet on. About the task you gave me. I found him hiding in Peshmi and gave him his punishment. Okay, so now I have a choice. I can take the money. Thank you, Vexadavian, for removing this long, festering thorn from my side. 'Tis good to know you can be trusted to handle things with an appropriate level of tactfulness. A bounty I promised, and a bounty you shall have. 300 denarii and not a copper less. So I can take the money, or I can say this is blood money I can't accept. If I say I can't accept, I'll get honor. But I'm going to take the money, though. Because I want money. Let me check something. I believe my stats are... No. Reports. Yes, honor. I think I gain honor if I turn down the money. But I don't... And I think I can lose honor doing some things. I can actually gain infamy. Honor... Friends, enemies, renown. Okay. Let's ask this guy if he has any tasks. See if he's got something else to do. Oh, he's got to deliver a letter to Emir Aem of the Saradin Sultanate, who's in Berea currently. Yeah, sure. He is in Berea, which is way down there. And who are we delivering this to? Emir? He's... Okay. He's Lord of Fashara. Where's Fashara at? Oh, okay. Now hold on a second. Notes, factions. Hold on one second. Now, aren't the Kurgats at war with the Saranids? You know, I have no way of knowing what the letter could be about, but, let's head to Berea. Man, I'm fast. Can I ever catch them? Nope. He's somewhere around Berea. Oh my god, I love this so much. Who was it? Emir Aem? Oh good, he's at the castle. Then I won't have to hunt for him. Oh, a tournament's here! Oh man, I am totally joining that tournament. That's what we're doing this video. But first, let me head to the castle and give this guy his letter. Where you at? Oh, here's Serenid. A Serenid castle. Looks really cool. I like the orange and white. Okay. Lady Balthin. Sup? I'm at your service. I must beg my leave. Emir Atis? No. Emir Aem. What's up, dude? Oh. Well. Same to you, buddy. I bring a message from Sanjar Khan. Okay, so that's all we have to do there. We don't have to return to Sanjar Khan. He'll get word that we delivered the letter. Now, I definitely want to join that tournament. Alright, let's do this. Okay, now tournament, I can actually bet on myself when I fight. I'm at tier 1 with there's 64 participants. Let's see who the participants are. Vechs, Davian, that's me. Katrin's actually entered. That's funny. Kratos, Dranton, Zarina. Hey, wait a minute. That must mean these people might be in the tavern. I should go check after the tournament if they're still and I might if they're still in the thing and I might be able to hire them. There's a sword sister. Well, minor spoilers. That's what the peasant women turn into one day. Sword sisters. They're pretty cool. I will place a bet on myself. I will bet 500 dinar. Oh, yeah. Let's try fighting. So it looks like I'm on red team. I'm on foot with arrows and a dagger. Oh, great. Is it really me versus these guys? Well, I just took out the sword sister. Oh, boy. Dude, I can't lose now. Die! I got a dagger. Fucking stupid little dinky dagger. Alright. I'm gonna place another bet on myself. 10-1. Oh, yeah. I'm almost at... Alright, I'm yellow team this time, and I've got a sword, and I'm mounted. Good. Come on. I want to turn this way. It's easier to attack on the right side. Hit him. Boop! Boop! Okay. Yellow team master race! Yeah! Hang it! Oh, I knocked out the horse. Wow. Yeah, you can kill horses too. Can I hurt the horse? Oh, nobody's mounted it, so I can't hurt it if nobody's mounted it. I just knocked that guy right off the horse. Did we win? Oh my god, I think I can win this. How many rounds are remaining? We're at tier 3. Oh man. I think I have barely enough money to cover these bets here. If I lose the tournament, though, I'm going to be broke. Like, completely wiped out. However, if I win, I'm going to get a ton of money. So it's kind of like gambling, although at least you have your own skill. And the important thing about the tournament is not to get kind of screwed on, like, what weapons it gives you. Like, hopefully you can make use of what it ends up giving you. All right. Give him... Oh, yeah. I'm kind of owning these people with the bow here. Oh, shit. Oh, thank God. Anything left? I'm blue team. Oh, I'm blue team, right? Oh, no. No, no, no. Oh, no, 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 no. Dagger! Help me, blue guy! Thank you. Thank you, blue guy. Who are you? Good. Okay. Place a bet. Oh. I can only bet... a little bit here. I think that was the last of my money. Red team. I've got javelins, it looks like. Can I just stab this guy with my javelin? I'm pretty sure I can. Oh, you hit X, by the way, to switch... how to use weapons. I gotta get off this wall. I'm stuck on it. Get off the wall. Do I have anything other than javelins? No, I don't. I'm stuck with javelins. How about you stop shooting me with arrows? How about that? I'm trying to use my javelin as a spear. But it's not going so well. Get off me, you little turd! Alright, let's get some distance. I think it's because it's so short. Okay, we got some distance. Got him. That's what I was trying to do. Who's left? Two teams with one fighter each. I don't have enough money to place any more bets. This is it. Fight in the next round. Oh, no. He's got a horse and I'm on foot? What the fuck, game? Oh, God. I'm going to cut the horse out from under him if I can. Oh, no. He's just going to ride around and do the... I'm going to cut your horse out from under you, and then I'm going to kill you with this wooden sword. Come on. Die, horse! Oh, yeah. Don't worry, kids. The horse is not dead. It's just knocked unconscious because we're using blunt weapons. Ah! My money! Yes! Oh, my God. I'm going to get so much rewards for this. Oh, I'm not even done yet. And I still can't place any more bets because I'm out of money. All right, we got to win this. Oh, good. I'm on a horse. Who's my enemy? Oh, my enemy's shooting at me. Aw, this isn't even fair. I feel sorry for you, buddy. That was kind of anticlimactic, actually. Yes! Oh, nice. And I gained a lot of reputation with the town for winning that. Oh, so good. So good. Huh. That felt kind of like a boss fight. That was fun. And we ranked up. Now we actually got some money. Let's see what we can do with it. Get my stats up. Like that. Can I get more into riding? Alright, riding level 4. That should qualify me for most horses in this game. Pathfinding and spotting, I want that up to 4 each. And let's get power throw and power draw up more to make sure I can use all the... that should qualify me for most of the throwing weapons and bows in the game. And I'll say done for now. Oh, that was awesome. Alright, let's head back into Purple People Land. And I'm honestly not worried about bandits at this point because my party is so long. So... Wait, I hear battle. Oh, wait, no. How's my food doing? Food's fine. Let me head back down to Berea, because I thought there may have been people down there I may wanted to recruit. And because I can just do this control space thing, it actually doesn't take that long. Let's head to the tavern. Are there people here I can recruit? I'd like some more heroes for my party. A wandering scald. A book merchant. A ransom broker, a mercenary swordsman, a tavern keeper. Oh, looks like I may have missed them. Dang. Huh. I'm almost tempted to buy a book. How much money do I have? I need to keep 10,000 for the enterprise I want to start. Eh. These are really expensive. These are more late game items, so I think I'll hold off on that. One of the ones I want to do is try to get my leadership up as much as I can. And then once I have trouble raising my leadership, is just use a book to get that one more skill point onto it, is what I'd kind of like to do. So let's use our warp drive to accelerate time and get back to Tulga. Okay. Let's see. Let's take a look at the tavern and see if there's anybody. Oh, there's Elaine. Belligerent drunk. Some sort of animal. What's up, buddy? Okay, so the kick is kind of useful if you're using a spear and you need to get someone off of you to get like another foot or two between you. Such a waste. Anyway. I'm trying to holster. I thought it was, Anyway, whatever. Alayan, I want to talk to you. You there, good man. Be so kind as to fetch me another drink. Yeah, I'm not the tavern keeper, buddy. My most humble apologies. So, he's kind of snooty. I was my father's son and his heir, but my mother died and my father remarried. His new wife thought her son should inherit. She could not move against me openly, but the other day I fed a pot of suet that had been left out for me to one of my hounds, and it keeled over. I accused my stepmother, but my father, befuddled by her witchcraft, refused to believe me and ordered me to leave his sight. So, stepmother from hell. I hope to offer my sword to some worthy captain, as it is the only honorable profession for a man of my birth, apart from owning land. So apparently, if you're nobility, the only things you ought to be doing is owning land and killing peasants. So, he's condemned to make my bed among thieves, vagabonds, merchants, and the other riffraff. So, man, medieval society was kind of a... people were dicks. So, join my company. Yeah, you're a gentleman. Whatever. Fine, here's your 300 gold. He doesn't want to associate with the common soldiers, like I give a damn. So, let's say I recruit somebody who's one of the heroes. He's like a ex-bandit, and they'll argue with each other, and their relations can get bad enough where one of them will want to leave your party. I think I disabled that. They'll complain, but they'll never leave. So you can basically build whatever kind of party you want. You have the freedom to get whatever heroes you want. Because before, they would be incompatible with each other. And that, I mean, from a role-playing standpoint, it makes sense. But then again, from a role-playing standpoint, I think it'd be cool to have the freedom to have whatever party you want. And that was more fun for me, so I changed it like that. So we've got two people now. And this guy probably needs a horse. A horse, my kingdom for a horse. Let's go to the horse merchant. Not the armor merchant. The horse merchant. Can we just get him like a plain old horse for now? Arms. Do you have a mace? Like a cheap mace I can give him so he can help me capture units? Keyword there being cheap. No, he doesn't. There's a light crossbow. That's not much money. And I'll buy some bolts. Let's see if I can outfit this guy. And what do you have? You've got the mace, right? Yeah, you've already got a mace. So you need... Oh, you have nothing. Here's your crossbow. Here, put a hat on. And have a horse. Yeah, my guys have terrible equipment right now. But we're just starting out in the game, so it'll be a while. And you'll notice that I haven't been spending money on my troops yet. I'm trying to save up money. Alright. So let's talk to the guildmaster. Here. Tolga. So you can ask him a lot of questions here, but I want to buy land in the town for productive enterprise. And if your relation's too low with the town, he'll refuse you. So, I want a weavery and dye works to make velvet from silk and dye. Yeah. Okay. Awesome. So this'll earn me about 1,000 monies per week. And in the short term, what that essentially does is... reports, view weekly budget. I can just, it'll cover the cost of my troops and net me a little profit. But what I'm after right now is just, I can essentially run my party for free and still make some profit on it. Okay, so we've sort of thrown our lot in with the Kurgats. We're not officially part of them, but we've bought land in their territory and opened a factory here. And I can actually even visit the place, I believe. Yeah, visit your dye works. I can actually come here. This is my dye works that I just bought. Here they will manufacture a velvet from silk and dyes. And this guy's... he runs the place. So I think I'll just camp here for 2 days. Until it opens. Shouldn't take too long if I just wait here. And you can see as I wait, you see a bunch of events happening. People fighting battles, people getting taken prisoners, people escaping from being prisoner. Villages getting looted. I really hope if I can become a lord of the Kurgats that my, is this thing done yet? View weekly budget report. Yes, it is. Great. So every week, instead of losing money every week, I'll actually make like 700 silver every week. So that's pretty cool. That's really important. I'm not hemorrhaging money every week now. Okay, let's see. So, let's see. Let's go over the accounts. They produce velvet worth blah, 2380 dinar each week. The colony of raw silk costs 1084 and the laborers 24. Purchase dye. Okay, so 1055 a week. So that's pretty good. Making pretty good profit here. Now, what he can do is keep the raw goods he produces in a warehouse, and I can take them and actually go sell them myself if I think I can find a better deal for them. If I don't, he'll function completely automatically, and he'll just operate until I tell him to stop buying and selling, buying raw materials, manufacturing velvet, and then selling it into the marketplace. And I think the goods will actually show up here in the market, I think. Maybe. I'm actually not sure now. Anyway, let me buy some more bread. Just to make sure we don't run low on food. Here, have some stuff. There we go. Alright, we've achieved our very first goal of this LP. We have... We got our first factory up and running in Tolga. How fast am I? 5.0? How fast are they? 5.9. Damn it. Stupid desert bandits. They're all mounted. They're very quick. You know what I could do? Hold on. Let me check some. If I upgrade these guys. I guess I will. Now that I've opened up that first shop, I guess I will upgrade my guys. There we go. I'll have a small but well-trained force. Will I ever be able to catch these people? Apparently, yes. They stopped. Wow. They must have wanted the fight. Maybe they think I can, they can take me. I think I'll order my guys to hold up here. I want Davian Guard on that side, on the flanks. I want the infantry up front, and I want the archers right up here on this hill. Cavalry, up on the other flank over there, please. Now, this isn't going to be a pushover battle. They've actually got a lot of forces. Now, I'm not sure if they're going to try to skirmish with us or if they're going to charge right into us. They're desert bandits, so they might be horsemen. Maces, spears. Well, one thing I notice immediately is that their armor is not nearly as good as the Sea Raiders, and my archers are picking them apart quite easily. Alright, let's order my cavalry to charge, and let's order the Davian Guard to charge. So my cavalry should have been... I don't even know if I have any cavalry right now. But Davian Guard's going to charge in from the flank. It did help a lot that we started out up on a hill, and they charged uphill at us, which slows them down, and gave my archers more time to shoot at them. And you can see that they've pretty much got like cloth armor. Their armor's not very good. They're essentially built for speed. I think actually, yeah, I hit his horse. Shield's doing its job. It took some arrows for me. Oh, there's the slave hunter. He's got pretty good gear. Alright. How do we do? Did we capture some of them? Yes, we did. Ooh! Yes, gimme. Who can I get rid of? I'll drop... I'll drop some more huntsmen, I guess. There we go. And let's upgrade some more of these guys. And we've actually got some... Yeah, Slave Hunter, nice. And the Kurgats, they eventually upgrade... The Kurgat Skirmisher, yeah. Is it the tribesmen go to the I forget what they're called, but they all become horsemen essentially, and the skirmisher gets to be a horseman, and the horseman can specialize as either a lancer or a horse archer, and I think for now I'll probably focus on horse archers maybe. Oh, buy javelins. Hello, Jareds. Actual like. Not crappy Jareds, too. I want to just take, like, all of them. No, I need that shield. A saddle horse. That's better than what I'm using right now. Got a new horse, too. Ooh, maces! Yes! You know, I think I might want to switch to a mace. I think I will. I think I'll ditch the spear and take a mace instead. And I'll take all the loot I can until I can't take any more. Okay. Let's go talk to you. And a sumpter horse. Well, I can give you this saddle horse, which I think is better, right? HP. Speed 37. Oh yeah, saddle horse is better. Okay, and you've got your mace, your shield. Can you use these? No, you cannot. Can you use this? You can't use that either? Dang, you suck. Okay, well, whatever. How about you? How are your skills? You don't have that either, okay. So you'd have to use crossbows, right? I'm pretty sure I've got another saddle horse, right? Like a normal one? Well, you can take a swayback one, I guess. And here's a mace for you. And I guess this shield is better than no shield. So there's your shield. And this cap is better than the one you're using now. So he's got a ranged weapon covered. Alright. So now both my guys have blunt weapons. We all have blunt weapons now, which is kind of cool. And we can take prisoners easier. And because we can take prisoners easier, we can make money easier. Now there's the camp defender, so next rank up she'll become a sword sister, which is pretty cool. Alright, we're done with that. That was a nice find. I think I should head back to Tulga now. Zoop! And head to the marketplace, sell some stuff. I guess I'll sell the spear. Yeah, I definitely want the mace, I think. I'll keep the Jareds on hand in case I want to use them. And I can sell the rest of this stuff. That'll make a 739. That's pretty good. Armor. Ooh, 12,000. 21,000. Look at that. Jeez. Thick Serenid Elite Armor, 18,000. Oh my gosh. That's so expensive. Ooh, now the Rusty Coat of Plates, I could actually afford that. That's plus 49. I mean, it's actually sometimes handy to find these negative modifiers because it makes the item cheaper. And even something like a negative modifier coat of plates is still much better than like 49 versus 36. It's still much better than what I'm using now. So I think I could actually equip myself and say maybe this and this. No, I can't afford to do that. I would have really liked to. Sad. Makes me sad. But yeah, that improved body armor is very nice. Although I kind of want something other than this. I should probably use this for now just because I found one. But there is a specific armor I'd like to have and specific boots. So I guess I'll just pay that for now. But this makes me a lot tankier than I used to be. That's a pretty big upgrade right there. Let's hand the... I guess I'll give it to you, because your armor is really crappy. Yeah, it's just a tabard. There you go. Have some metal armor. Okay. And sell that back. Let's see. Oh, by the way, there's a cracked siege crossbow. I'm pretty sure an actual, like, normal one would be 60-something damage. And I have, I've got 49 HP. So if I get shot, like I was saying on, if I put this to normal, and I've got 49 HP, and I get shot by something that does like 63 damage, I'm gonna die in one hit, and like Roto Crossbowmen carry, I think they carry siege crossbows. So that's why I'm not doing that, because it's really lame to just, the battle starts, some random crossbow bolt hits you, and you just die instantly. And in the vanilla game, the battle would instantly end with your army losing. Because it's my mod that actually lets your army keep fighting after you've gone down. So that's, I don't think that's really cool. So that's why I made those changes, and I think the game is better for it. Okay. Let's see. Is Dudeface here? Akadin Noyan? Yeah, let me go to the castle and ask him and see if he's got any more jobs for us. Is a Kurgat Horseman? Another Kurgat Horseman. Hey. No, not you. Is Sandra Khan here? Oh, he's not. Oh, but I don't know where he is, though. So I actually do need to go talk to this guy and ask him. Hi. Oh, did he say something to me? I missed it. Dang. Oh, well. He probably said something like, I heard about you helping out with something, and so I like you more now. I wish to ask you something. I wish to know the location of something. Sharwa Castle. Okay, thank you. Thank you. Sharwa Castle is... where? Down there. Oh, he must be fighting. So let's activate our warp drive and head down there. I bet he's probably, if I had to guess, he might be over there looting Tazjanat. Yep. Is that him? Yep. Nice. Hey, maybe I could perform a mercenary for him. I wish to ask you something. How goes your war? Yeah, tell me about your war with Serenids. We've been hitting them hard, giving them a little chance to recover. So they've been winning. Do you have any tasks for me? You probably know that I am the lord of the town of Tulga. However, it has been months since Tulga has delivered the taxes and rents due me as its rightful lord. Apparently, the populace there has grown unruly lately, and I need someone to go there and remind them of their obligations, and to persuade them if they won't listen. If you go there and raise the taxes they owe me, I will grant you 1/5 of everything you collect. Sure, I'll be your hitman. Okay, do not let them fool me. Alright, cool. You have fun burning this peasant village to the ground. I will go take the money from the peasants in your town. And I'll be right back in a bit. Warp drive! That is so cool. That is so cool. Okay. Where are you going? Traveling to Tarama? Is he gonna see? Is he attacking it? Yeah, he might be. Anyway. So, Tulga. Now, unfortunately, this is gonna. Kingdom of Swati and Red Oaks have made peace. Okay, cool. Vagers and Nords have made peace. Serenid. The Kurgats and the Serenids have made peace. Okay, so they all decided to just make peace at the same time. Oh boy. Well, let's collect the taxes due to Sanger Khan. Oh, it's based off trade school. That's cool. It'll take 2 days. Well, let's start collecting. The people of Tulga are outraged at your demands and decry it as nothing more than extortion. They're getting very restless and they may react badly if you keep pressing them. I don't care. I have orders from the Khan. And he's going to be mad at me if I... Alright, well, looks like we have to put down some peasants who don't want to pay their share of taxes. Yay! Police state! Yay! I get to be the riot police! Whee! What? Ah. Die, peasants! I mean, not die, I mean, slave away in your farms and make more money for us. Haha! Respect the upper classes! I make a good noble, I think. Yeah, we're awesome! We beat down peasants! Alright, we're awesome. I'm definitely gonna lose a reputation at Tulga for this, but... Oh well. That money has to keep flowing in. Well, our kingdom's gonna need it when the vile Serenids inevitably attack again. Okay, so we've got the money. Yeah, they're not very happy with me, but I'll have to deal with it. Alright. Oh, Sanjar Khan came back. Let's go talk to him. So we get to keep... how much money do I have here? 8,700, basically. Let's go to the castle. And I think I get to keep 1/5 of this, right? About the task he gave me. Here are all the taxes from Tulga. Comes up to 73.19. Well done, Vexstavian. Very well done indeed. You are truly the right man for the job. I promised you 1/5 of the taxes, so that amounts to 1464 dinar. If you give me 58.55, you may keep the difference. A good result for everyone, eh? Yeah, I think so. Well, except for maybe the peasants I had to beat down, but, you know, who cares about them? They're a bunch of dirt farmers, and they need to respect their betters. Alright, let's go to the tavern. And I think... Oh, that's a cool-looking plant. It's a nicely decorated tavern. Tavern keeper? Hey, what's up? I have prisoners to sell. Yeah, you see how there was, like, not a ransom broker here, and how I didn't need to go look around all over the place? Because, I mean, I'd have to go start going to just random towns hoping to find one. And that's annoying. You're just going to have to trust me on that. Hey, those boots are, I can get those boots now. Do I want those boots? Or do I want to try to save up another 10k and get another business in another one of these cities here? I think that's what I want to do. I think I want to save up. Ooh, hey, what's that? Ooh, step bandits. They're 3.9. I'm 3.2. I'm going to try following them anyway in the hopes that maybe they'll get their nerve up to come around and fight me. Nope. Oh, there's a chance right over there to... Well... Alright, so we made some weekly money. Oh, look at all these bandits. I want some. Gimme. Some step bandits. Alright, everybody stop here. Davian Guard, follow me. I'll give this mace. Alright, let's go try to capture some people. Hey, there they are. Hey, we already got one. Oh boy, I'm kind of surrounded. I'm just going to keep swinging this mace and hope for the best. Boop, 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 boop. I booped your horse down too. Boop. I'm just going to boop everything. Hey, maybe we could take a horse prisoner. Do you think the horse would make a good prisoner? Nah, probably not. Eh, turn around. Turn. Turn. Done it. Done it. Done it. Yeah. Yeah. Alright, you know what? I'm just gonna start throwing things on you. Maybe I can get the horse out from under you. Yep, got the horse. Gotcha. Okay. Is that all of them? Oh, that's right. Davian Guard is still following me. Let's command everybody to just charge and mop up the rest of them. I get a good hit on that guy. Ooh, I got him! I'm getting better with these Jareds. Alright, I see another guy over there. Now, there's probably somebody watching who is cringing at watching me target a poor little horse. Aw, poor horsey. Well, don't feel bad, because you've been watching me kill people, and you haven't felt bad yet. And this is just make-believe. These are pixels. It's not a real animal. So calm yourself, because I know you. Some people get really bit out of shape about animal abuse. If it makes you feel any better, a few weeks ago I rescued a kitten from a grocery store parking lot, and it's joined our family now. His name is Basil, and he's adorable. So don't get bent out of shape over imaginary pixel horses, okay? Okay, I had to address that. Do you know there's one person out there who's just, like, really upset about horses? Like this kind of thing? Hitting the horse. They're like, no, don't hit the horse. Don't hit the horse that doesn't actually exist and it's just, you know, on your computer. Okay. And that actually doesn't kill this guy either. He'll get a fresh horse. Yeah, ha ha! He doesn't even care. Look at him. He's like, yeah, you killed the horse. Ha ha. Alright. We lost a slave driver and... Ooh. Yoink. And more manhunters. I'll just get rid of the last of the huntsmen. There we go. More loots. All the loots for me. And I'm gonna go help this guy too. This is a good way to gain easy relations with people. I just rush to this guy's aid. Now this should be a mop-up with our two parties here, except for the fact that they're horsemen and they'll run all over the place and be hard to find. And I've already got my max of prisoners. I've got 10 out of 10 right now, so I don't need to worry about taking prisoners. So I think I'm just going to throw Jareds into the mass of people here indiscriminately and see what happens. Apparently I'll get people. Good job, buddy. Why do you guys have such stupid haircuts? I swear to God, I'm about to leave the Kurgats just because they have really stupid haircuts. It's bugging me that much. Hang it! Move! Out of the way! I may hit you. Maybe on accident, maybe not on accident. Who knows? Whoa! Whee! Where's the enemy? Let's check the map. Oh, there's one single red dot running away. Run, red dot! You can make it! Run, red dot! Oh, you poor little red dot. You think the red dot's... Oh my God, look at this mass chasing this one guy. Oh, I kind of feel sorry for him. Oh, he died. Yay, we won! Psh! I think I just threw a javelin into somebody's horse. Oh my God. Thank you for your help. Yes, yes, you're Amirzanoian. All right, I helped you. Yes, cool. Okay. Nope. Yeah. There we go. Okay, let's go sell these prisoners, and I think we'll take a break there. That was fun. Warp speed. We're back in Toga. Visit the tavern. Maybe I can try smoothing things over with this place if I buy... is that 1,000? Yes. Let's buy everyone in the city a bottle of wine. Hey, that got them back up. That got them to, back to zero at least. So they don't hate me anymore. Although it did set me back 1,000. I just don't want to let my reputation go so low with the city. Because my business is here. Just sell all this. Cool. Okay. We're doing good on food. And we need to go to the tavern and sell these prisoners. Prisoners to sell. Sell, 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 sell. There we go, 4,000. Not bad. I need another 6,000 for another factory in another city. Okay, so I think we'll take a break here. We've made some good progress in the Kurgat Khanate. We're not awesome enough to be a noble lord yet. We're going to have to win battles and keep gaining renown to do so. And there's no wars going on, so I don't think they're going to hire me as a mercenary. But I can keep doing individual tasks for cities and lords here, and maybe try to get my reputation up. I'd like to keep getting my reputation up for Dashbiga, because it's a central village, and I think it's probably a good village to recruit from. Although, I don't really need any new recruits right now. My party's full. So there's that. Yeah, okay. So that's it for this episode. Thank you guys very much for watching, and until next time, take it easy.